So good morning students. So we can discuss about fracture mechanics. Why is fracture important? So you have to observe that any ships or any planes or any vehicles or any automobiles, so it's a breakdown. So suddenly it is not breakdown due to sudden failure means it should be an accident or something happens. Okay, suddenly when you going on the vehicle or plane, suddenly it is not breakdown or suddenly it is not fall down. That is due to suddenly it is occurs due to only the when the accident. That means when one automobile collide with any other automobile or any other objects, then only the breakdown occurs. That is called as accident. Okay, so that means why you have to study the fracture. So that means fracture we have to study where the weakness part of the materials are present. Okay, so what is happening due to that accidents and all we can study by the use of fracture mechanics. Okay, see in this figure, brittle fracture can be caused sudden failure. So that means you know that there are two types of material. One is brittle material, another one is ductile material. So brittle materials are fracture more than the ductile material. So for example, if you observe that any car accident, suddenly you have to observe that the glass of that car will be fall down or break down immediately because it is a brittle. Okay, so that means in this you have to observe that Aloha Airlines Boeing 737-297 operating from Hilo to Honolulu at Kualoa Airport on April 28 in 1988 after its fuselage was torn away during the flight, failure attributed to fatigue fracture of the panels forming the fuselage in the section weakened by the rivets. Okay, so that means in this figure you should have to observe it is not collided with anything at all. So that means when it is operating from that station airport, so in 1988 April, so that means the fuselage was damaged due to the weaker section. That means the weakened by the rivet. That means the ductile material and brittle materials are both are there, whereas that means the brittle material immediately fractured due to some air or whatever it may be due to the weakening of the rivet. That means when you riveted with that means the brittle material fastened with the ductile material with the help of rivets. So due to the riveting force, automatically the ductile strength will be loosened. Okay, and why fracture again? The failure of the Liberty ships. That means you should have to heard that in the first module you can study that the Liberty ships are the main thing we are concentrate more because the Liberty ships are more in the World War II. So that means how fractures occurs and all we can discuss already. We can discuss in the first module itself. Okay, and brittle fracture, that means collapse of Hoshi Bridge during the Chichi earthquake in Taiwan. That means in Taiwan 1999, failure of concrete pipe. See, observe here in this area. There is a, so that means this place you have to observe that, and the bridge is fallen down. Okay, so that means case study of how Huron Bridge, or that is Harbor Bridge. See, observe here. This, that means round up is there. That means here and this place and all visible crack in the flange. That means visible. You have to visible, you can see the flange cracks and all. Crack suddenly appeared of 2-3 steel girders of the Huron Bridge. Triaxial constraint due to a bracing system lead to the brittle crack propagation. And why fracturing mechanics is important? Conventional design proceeds based only on some maximum stress criteria are not adequate under all circumstances. That means if you want to consider any automobile, anything, so that means the strength of that material you can decide first. Okay, so that means conventional design is procedure based only on some maximum stress. That means if you go for conventional design, that means conventional design means, so nowadays you should have to know that the whatever the design they are doing, design they do, that means you can first you should have to check with the stress strain, and by using analysis like FEM analysis, ANSYS and all, you can check the strength of the material, and that is you can going. So before that there is a conventional design. First you have to draw the diagram and then construct a prototype. You have to make it and then check the strength and all, and then go for another method. Okay, that means and then after prototyping is okay, then for okay manufacturing. Okay, so it is all, it will takes a time, but nowadays it is not like that. Okay, next, fracture mechanics determines failure based on the interaction between applied stress crack and material parameters. Okay, so that means fracture mechanics determines failure based on the interaction between applied stress, crack and material parameters. Instead of magnitude of stress or strain, fracture mechanics is concerned with the distribution of stresses and displacements in the vicinity of a crack tip. Fracture mechanics is particularly applicable to the failure of brittle materials, but under certain circumstances to other materials as well as. Okay. So fracture mechanics mainly applicable to brittle materials, but under circumstances, under certain circumstances, it will applicable to all material, other materials as well, like ductile and other materials. Okay. So ductile materials, we can't say it is not fracture, but it is also fracture, but to some extent it will does not fracture immediately like brittle fracture, brittle material. The difference between theoretical material fracture strength calculated from the interatomic bonding energy and the values actually measured is enormous, perhaps 2 or 3 orders of magnitude. Griffith in 1920 concluded that any real material has flaws, micro cracks or other defects that would have the effect of concentrating the stress in highly localized regions. So it means you are already studied the Griffith's law. So Griffiths in 1920 concluded that any material has flaws, it should have some flaws or micro cracks or other defects that would have the effect of concentrating the stress in highly localized regions. For example, manufacturing defects, if during the manufacturing inside there is any blow holes or some cracks should be there, that is also initiated for fracture. So this is the background. Okay, these are all you should have. That means you are already studied the modes of failure. One is opening mode, in plane shear mode, out plane tear. That is also called as tearing mode. Mode of crack. That means how it is happening. These are all you are already studied. Stress. What is stress intensity factor? Okay, linear elastic fracture mechanics (LEFM). Typical toughness values. These are all LEFM continuous. These are all okay. So our next is going to for R curve. Non-linear fracture mechanics R curve. Okay, so for R curve, so for example, if you draw a curve like this, so that means R curve for especially for ductile materials we can consider here. So that means the crack resistance curve. R curve is nothing but crack resistance curve. The R curve resist R is the energy required by the crack per unit increase in area. That means the crack resistance is the energy required by the crack per unit increase in area. It characterizes the material behavior. So it means R curve characterizes the material behavior as it will characterize. We can observe that for most of the energy engineering materials, crack resistance increases with crack length as shown in figure. That means for any engineering materials, if you take, the resistance increases with crack length. That means if the area is increases, automatically the crack length also increases. Okay. A minimum value Ri, that means Ri is needed for make the crack growth. Crack resistance depends on the plastic zone size for a large plastic zone size. Okay, so crack resistance, that means R curve is dependent on the plastic zone size. That is, R curve is mainly depending upon the plastic zone size. Okay, as the crack advances, plastic zone size becomes larger. That means crack advances. That means crack is, if it is crack is more, the plastic zone size also becomes large, which in turn requires higher energy. It will requires higher energy for crack growth. Interestingly, the shape of R curve is not found to depend much on the initial length of the crack for most engineering materials. However, a R curve depends considerably on temperature and thickness of the plate. So that means the main R curve, it is depends upon the temperature and as well as the thickness of the plate or the material. That means R curve mainly depends on environmental also, it is affected. For example, if the some cold environment, that means it crack, that means corrosion is more, automatically the material will lose its strength. Automatically there fracture is more, we can expect more fracture. Okay, so this is about the R curve. That means R curve, that means if the plate size increases, R curve is also increases. So that means crack R curve mainly depends upon the temperature and the thickness of the material, second factor. And R curve, when the R curve increases, the energy is also the energy required for the cracking is also require more. Okay, these are all the 3 points in required the R curve. That means crack resistance curve. So R curve for stable and unstable crack growth. It is known that crack to grow, the energy release rate of a crack must be greater than the crack resistance. That means crack growth, the energy release rate, that means energy release rate of a crack must be greater than the crack resistance. That means whatever the energy released during the crack, that is greater than the crack resistance. So you have to observe in this figure, G, that means GR versus crack size, you can stay. See, the effect of the toughening mechanism ahead of the crack tip is sometimes represented by a rising resistance curve or R curve. R curve is also nothing but rising resistance curve. Rising resistance curve, or simply it is called as resistance curve, where the critical energy release rate is not constant, but the changes with the crack extension. As the applied stress increases, the energy release rate G changes until the G function becomes tangential to the R curve. To the crack extension is stable. Condition for stable crack growth is given by the equation G is equal to R is equal to dG by dA. DR by DA, unstable crack growth, that means there are two equations, one is for stable and another is for unstable crack growth. So this is for non-linear fracture mechanics, cohesive crack. So it is, okay, this is about this. So next, if you go to our applications of fracture mechanics. Fracture mechanics is often used in the framework of the finite element method to simulate the failure of a structure or body through crack propagation. So by using the FEM analysis or finite element method analysis simulation, the failure of structure of a body through crack propagation, you should have to analyze how the crack will propagate by using the FEM method. Cracking in a pavement overlay system, that is using on the concrete bodies, for example bridges or buildings, etc. So you can also analyze. And failure of pipe due to excessive internal pressure, for example line pipelines, for example gas pipelines or oil pipelines or water pipelines, sometimes you can observe that some small leakage occurs, okay. So that is due to some internal pressure is more there, whereas the thickness of the pipe or the strength of the pipe weaken and at some point, okay, so that can be analyzed, okay. There are the one is longitudinal view and another one see how the hole is become, that means see in this you can observe that here in this you have to observe that how the crack is forming. Here you can observe that here the crack is forming, okay. So next is, if you observe that there is a crack, probability fracture of brittle material here, okay. Defect sensitivity. So materials such as glass, ceramics, rigid polymers and concrete have low fracture toughness, making them vulnerable to the presence of crack like defects. Such defects sensitive materials are prone to brittle failure well before they can yield. So it means glass, for example, if you take glass, ceramics or rigid polymers, they can they are all brittle materials, they can yield immediately, okay. Moreover, many of these materials always contain cracks and flaws, consequently their tensile strength are very low. Okay, so that means this tensile strength is low. Tensile stresses versus compressive stress, if you do the experiment, you can, okay. So this is about the R curve, okay. So this completes the your R curve and J integral as well as the CTOD, crack tip opening displacement. Thank you.